Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to plan for cash flow using the direct method. There are two methods for calculating cash flow, the direct method and the indirect method. This tutorial focuses on the direct method, which calculates cash flow from income statement accounts. Revenue and income accounts, such as product revenue or service revenue listed on the income statement, are used to determine the sources of cash. Expenses or payments on the income statement are used to determine cash uses. On the cash flow statement, you can see the cash flow for your organization, which is comprised of cash sources and cash uses. Cash flow reporting records cash activity as it relates to the individual revenue and expense accounts. You can see the sources of cash by looking at the revenue components on the income statement. For example, revenue from product sales, services, and support are all sources of cash. Uses of cash are seen as expenses on the income statement. For example, operating expenses are a use of cash. There is a delay between the time you record revenue and the time you receive the cash. Similarly, there is a delay between the time when you accrue a payable, such as the purchase of raw materials, and when you pay out the cash for those materials. Here you can see sources of cash. You increase your cash by generating product sales, providing services and support, or from other revenue. Cash sources are configurable. Let's set up our assumptions for cash flow. You can use the direct method if you enabled revenue and expense planning. Here we set up assumptions for our sources of cash. Cash flow timing should always equal 100%. Let's see how our cash flow assumptions impact the cash flow calculation. You indicate the timing for when you expect to receive cash. For example, for product revenue for this market and product, we expect that 70% of the revenue will be collected within 30 days. 20% of that month's revenue will be collected within 60 days. And the remaining revenue will be collected within 90 days. So if we generate $100,000 from product revenue in January, 70% or $70,000 of cash is expected to be received in February, which is within the first 30 days after the sale. 20% or $20,000 is expected to be received in March, which is within 60 days of the sale. And the remaining 10% or $10,000 will be received in April or within 90 days of the sale. Uses of cash include expenses or payments. If you manufacture products, you spend cash for materials. You also spend cash to pay for loans, operating expenses, employee compensation, and taxes. Cash uses are configurable. For example, here we are showing you 5 cash uses that are available out of the box. You can add or remove accounts as necessary. The assumptions and calculations for cash uses behave similarly to cash sources. Let's see how our cash flow assumptions for cash uses impact the cash flow calculation. You indicate the timing for when you expect to pay out cash. For example, for payment of material, we expect that 75% of the payment will be made within 30 days. The remaining 25% of that month's payment will be made within 60 days. So, if we have $100,000 of materials that were purchased in January, 75% or $75,000 of cash is expected to be paid out in February, which is within the first 30 days after the cost was incurred. The remaining 25% or $25,000 is expected to be paid out in March, which is within 60 days of incurring the cost. The February purchase also impacts March's cash flow. When you use the direct cash flow method, the accounts receivable, accounts payable, and accrued compensation accounts are calculated from the cash flow process. For example, accounts receivable equals the prior period's accounts receivable plus total revenue minus cash from sales. Please note that the roll-up rule should be run prior to opening the balance sheet. In this tutorial, you saw how to plan for cash flow using the direct method for Enterprise Planning Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.